Your number, sir. Thank you. Lot 663, then, ladies and gentlemen. A poster from this house's production of Hannibal by Chalumeau.
Showing here.
Do I have 10 francs for this? 5, then. 5? Thank you. 5 IMD. 6? 6, do I see 7? 7. Against you, sir, 7. 8. 8 once. Selling twice. So, to Raoul, Vicomte de Chagny. Thank you very much, sir. Lot 664, then, ladies and gentlemen. A pistol and human skull from the 1831 production of Robert the Diable by Meyerbeer.
Showing here.
10 francs for this. 10, thank you. 10 I am bid. 10 still. 15, thank you. 15 I am bid. Going at 15. Your number, sir?
Thank you.
Lot 665, then, ladies and gentlemen. A papier-mâché musical box in the shape of a barrel organ.
Showing here.
Attached, the figure of a monkey in Persian robes playing the cymbals. This item, discovered in the vaults of the theater, still in working order, ladies and gentlemen. Commence at 20 francs. Oh, come, come. Ladies and gentlemen, 15 then. 15? Thank you. 15 I am bid. Yes? 20? From you, sir. Thank you very much. 25 on my left. Thank you, madame. 25 I am bid. 30? Selling at 30 francs. 30 once. 30 twice. So, to the Vicomte de Chagny, thank you once again, sir.
Boy. A collector's piece, indeed. Every detail, exactly. Your velvet lining and your figurine of lead. Will you still play when all the rest of us are dead?
Lot 666, then. A chandelier, until recently believed destroyed. Some of you may recall the strange affair of the Phantom of the Opera, a mystery never fully explained. We are told, ladies and gentlemen, that this is the very chandelier which figured in the famous disaster. Our workshops have restored it and newly wired it for the electric light so that we may get a hint of how magnificent it will look when reassembled. Perhaps we may frighten away the ghost of so many years ago with a little illumination. Gentlemen!
Thank you.
As a personal favor, you would oblige us with a private rendition? Unless, of course, Monsieur objects.
My manager commands. Monsieur Reyes?
My diva commands. Will two bows be sufficient introduction?
Quite sufficient.
Maestro.
Carlotta will be back. You think so, monsieur? I have a message here from the opera ghost.
God in heaven, you're all obsessed.
He merely welcomes you to his opera house. Commands that you continue to leave box 5. Empty for his use. And reminds you that his salary is due.
His salary?
Monsieur Lefebvre paid him 20,000 francs a month. Perhaps you could afford more with the Vicomte. De Chagny, as your patron.
Madame, I was hoping to have made that announcement myself.
Will the Vicomte be at the performance tonight, monsieur?
Yes, in our box.
Madame, who is the understudy for the role?
There is no understudy, monsieur. The production is new.
Christine Daae could sing it, sir.
The chorus girl.
She's been taking lessons from a great teacher.
Really? From whom?
I don't know, sir.
Oh, not you as well.
Can you believe it, Andre? A full house and we have to cancel.
Let us sing for you. Monsieur! She has been well taught.
Very well. From the beginning of the aria then, mademoiselle.
Thank you.
Nothing for my nerves, Andre.
Richard. That day, that not so distant day, when you were far away and free, if you ever find a moment, spare a thought for
Christine, where in the world have you been?
My dear, I was asked to give you this.
A red scarf. The attic. Little Lottie.
A tour de force. No other way to describe it.
What a relief. Not a single refund.
Richard, I think we've made quite a discovery, Miss Dye. Here we are.
Monsieur le Vicomte.
Gentlemen, if you wouldn't mind, this is one visit I should prefer to make unaccompanied.
As you wish, monsieur.
They appear to have met before.
Christine Kaye, where is your red scarf?
Monsieur?
You can't have lost it. After all the trouble I took. I was just 14 and soaked to the skin.
Because you had run into the sea to fetch my scarf. Oh, Roll! So it is you.
Christine. Little Lottie, let her mind wander.
Remember that too.
Little Lottie, am I from the of dolls or of goblins of shoes?
Or of riddles of rocks?
Or of things in the attic? Or of chocolates?
Father playing the violin?
As we read to each other, dark schools of the north.
No, what I love best, Lord, he said, is when I'm asleep in my bed and the angel of music sings songs in my head. Send the angel of music to you. Well, Father is dead, Ralph. And I have been visited by the angel of music.
No doubt of it. And now, we go to supper.
No, Ralph, the angel of music is very strict.
Well, I shan't keep you up late.
No, no.
You must change. And I must get my hat. 2 minutes. Little Lottie.
Things have changed, Row!
Insolent boy, this slave of fashion, asking me. Ignorant fool, this brave young suitor, sharing in my triumph.
Stay by my side, guide me.
watch. My Pandora! You little demon! Is this what you wanted to see? Curse! You little blind Delilah! You little viper! Now you cannot ever be free! Damn you! Curse you! Stranger,
no one likes a debtor, so it's better if my orders are obeyed.
who would have the gall to send this? Someone with a purer brain. These are boots like OG, who the hell they steam? Opera goats, it's really not amusing. It's abusing our position. In addition, he wants money. He's a funny sort of spectre. To expect a large retainer, nothing plainer. He is really quite insane.
My name is Quiet, where is she?
Well, how should we know?
I want an answer. I take it that you sent me this note.
What's all this nonsense?
Of course not.
Don't look at us.
He's not with you then.
Of course not.
We're in the dark. Monsieur, don't argue. Isn't this the letter you wrote?
And what is it that we're meant to have wrote? Written.
Do not fear for Miss Dying. Angel of music has her under his wing. Make no attempt to see her again.
Well, if you didn't write it, who did?
Where is he?
Ah, welcome back!
Your precious patron, where is he?
What is it now?
I have your letter, a letter which I rather resent.
And did you send it?
Of course not!
As if it were.
You didn't send it?
Of course not! What's going on?
Better tell me that this is not the letter you sent.
And what is it that I meant to have sent? Your days in the opera populaire are numbered. Christine Tidley will be singing on your behalf tonight. Be prepared for a great misfortune. Should you attempt to take the case? Far too many notes for my taste, and most of them about Christine. All we've heard since we came is Miss Dying's name.
Miss Dying has returned.
In which case I think our meeting is adjourned.
Where precisely is she now?
I thought it best that you would fall. She did rest.
May I see
her? Monsieur, she will sing no one.
Will she sing?
Will she sing?
Here, I have a note.
Let me see it,
please. Gentlemen. I have now sent you several notes of the most amiable nature, detailing how my theatre is to be run. You have not followed my instructions. I shall give you one last chance.
Christine Daae has returned to you, and I am anxious her career should progress. Of Il Muto, you will therefore cast Carlotta as the lead boy, and put Miss Dying in the role of Countess. The role which Miss Dying plays calls for charm and appeal. The role of the lead boy is silent, which I cast in a word, ideal.
I shall watch the performance from my normal seat in box 5, which will be kept empty for me. Should these commands be ignored, a disaster beyond your imagination will occur.
I remain, gentlemen, your obedient servant, O.G.
Christine, Christine, Christine!
Whatever next?
It's on a point of
hell, Christine! This is insane!
I know who said this, the flippant lover!
Indeed, can you believe this?
This is not your
sin,
Lara!
You are a star, and always will be seen. Lara, the man is mad.
Well, don't take orders.
If Dyer will be playing the page boy, the silent role, Carlotta will be playing the lead.
You don't deserve her.
It's in your sister, Marie, to look at
I'm
your public needs you. We need you too.
Would you not rather have your precious little Angelou?
Signora, no. The world wants you. Prima donna, first lady on the stage, your devotees are on their knees to implore you. Can you bow out when they're shouting your name? Think of how they all adore you. Prima donna, enchant us once again. Think of the views and of the cues from the theatre. Can you deny us the triumph in store? Sing a prima donna once more.
But do you really think that's wise, monsieur?
My dear André, there would appear to be no seats available other than box 5, Elizabeth.
It seems that Monsieur has
set my lady's heart aflame.
His lordship sure would die of shame.
His lordship is a laughing stock.
She tastes the cock of
wrath. Shame, shame, shame. This famous lady's gone for Hades. Shame, shame, shame.
Ah, nothing like the old operas.
The old scenery.
Old singers.
The old audience.
Every seat sold.
A disaster beyond imagination.
Serafino, your disguise is perfect. Why? Who can this be?
Gentle wife, admit your love and have thunder. My love, I'm put to England on affairs of state, and must leave you with your new maid.
Ah!
Then happily take the maid with me.
The old fool is leaving.
I suspect my young bride is untrue to me. I shall not leave, but shall hide over there to observe
sung by Miss Christine Dyer.
Well,
don't worry, I'm with you. And in the meanwhile, ladies and gentlemen, take it out. As I was saying, in the meanwhile, we shall be giving you the ballet from Act 3 of tonight's opera. Maestro. The ballet! Now.
Thank you.
accident.
Far behind you. Thank you. Monsieur Fernand.
Monsieur André.
Yeah, André, what a splendid
battle.
A poor look to a bright new year.
Quite a night, I'm impressed.
One on us, what's best. Here's to us. A toast to all the city.
Such a pity that the Phantom can't be here.
Thank you.
Why so silent, good messieurs? Did you think that I had left you for good? Have you missed me, good messieurs? I have written you an opera. Here I bring the finished score. Con one triumphant. I advise you to comply. My instructions should be clear. Remember, there are worse things than a shattered chandelier. Your chains are still mine. You will sing for me.
You've seen something, haven't you?
I don't know what I've seen. Please, don't ask me, monsieur.
Madame, for all our sakes!
Very well. It was years ago. There was a traveling fair in the city. Tumblers, conjurers, human oddities. I shall never forget him. A man... locked in a cage.
In a cage?
Oh, a prodigy, monsieur. Scholar, architect, musician.
A composer.
And an inventor too, monsieur. They boasted he had once built for the Shah of Persia a maze of mirrors.
Who was this man?
A freak of nature, or a monster than a man.
Deformed.
And that would seem it. And then he went missing. He escaped.
Go on.
They never found him. It was said he had died.
But he didn't die, did he?
The world forgot him, but I never can. For in this darkness I have seen him again.
This man.
I have said too much, monsieur.
No, wait.
Too much. There have been too many accidents.
Accidents? Madame Giry!
Ludicrous, have you seen the storm?
Simply ludicrous.
Here's the final straw.
This is lunacy, when you know my views.
Lunacy.
But we daren't refuse.
Not another chandelier.
Look, my friend, what we have here.
Andre, we my orchestrations. We need another first bassoon. Every note's overblown, and the third trombone has to go. The man could not be deaf, so please, preferably one who plays in tune.
Dear fan, and he's a fee, my opera. Some chorus members must be sacked. If you could find out which has a sense of pitch, wisely though, I managed to assign a rather minor role to those who cannot act.
Alternate!
Now,
it's not a fair, it's an alternate!
Signora, please, what's the matter?
Have you seen the size of my hand?
Signora, listen to me, so don't you as well? This is an insult. Please understand, your signora.
The pizza is good all for my aunt.
If you can call this gibberish act.
Here, sound, little flower.
Yes, Miss Dying, quite the lady of the hour. You have secured the largest role in this dumb one.
Christine, she doesn't have the voice.
Signora, please.
Then I take it you're agreeing.
She's behind this.
It appears we have no choice.
She's the one behind this, Christine Dyer. How dare you? I'm not a fool. You evil woman, how dare you? You think I'm blind? This isn't my fault. I don't want any part in this plot.
Miss Dyer, surely. But why not?
What does she say?
It's your decision, but why not?
She's backing out.
You have a duty.
I cannot sing it, duty or not.
Christine,
you don't have to. They can't make you.
Please, monsieur, another note. Fondest greetings to you all. A few instructions just.
must be from the first start. Carlotta must be forced to act, not a normal trick of strutting round the stage. Our Don Juan must lose some weight. It's not healthy in a man of Chianti's my managers must learn that their place is in an office, not the arts. As for Miss Christine Tyne, no doubt she'll do her best, it's true.
Ensnare our clever friend.
When is the dawn?
We shall play his game, perform his work, but remember we hold the ace. For if Miss Tyne sings, he is certain to attend.
We make certain the doors are locked. We make certain our men are there.
We make certain they're armed.
The curtain falls. His reign will end.
Madness!
I'm not so sure if it works.
Madness!
Time will turn.
Expect
a ballet.
Then help us!
Monsieur le Comte!
Instead of warning us,
help us!
I wish I could!
You'll make excuses!
What could it be if you're on the side?
She says that I'm nervous! Believe me, I intend no evil! Monsieur, be careful, we have seen
you! Say a boy, all you will!
We
are
on the way, Christina!
This is not
she is the one behind
us! Christina!
This
is what
you
mean!
You set a tool of me on a focus soul!
We'll be right back.
golden couch at Hayfield Moor, both happy his battlefield.
And those who would hang on me, Dunwan!
Chorus best, please. Dunwan! Signor Pianici, this is the phrase. Those who tangle with Don Juan, if you please.
Those who tangle with Don Juan.
No, really, but no. Those who tan, tan, tan.
And those who tangle.
His way is better, but at least he makes it sound like music.
Signor, would you speak that way in the presence of the composer?
The composer is not here. And if he were, I would.
Are you certain of that? Senior.
So, once again then, if you please, Signor Pianci, after seven. Five, six, seven.
Those who tangle with the world!
What is it to
world was shattered.
no claim on her, leave her. The words are wasted, consciousness shall never be yours. Christine, Christine, listen to me, whatever you may believe this man. This thing is not your father. Let her go. For God's sake, let her go. Christine,
no, no, monsieur. Such spirited words.
More tricks, monsieur.
Yes, monsieur, how far you dare go.
More deception, more violence.
That's right, keep walking this way.
Can't win her love by making her your prisoner.
I am here, monsieur, the angel of death. Don't stop, don't stop, don't go. So be it. Now, let it be war upon you both.
Understand my instructions. When you hear the whistle, take up your positions. I shall then instruct you to secure the doors. It is essential that all doors are properly secured.
But are we doing the right thing, Andre? Do you have a better idea?
Monsieur le Vicomte, am I to give the order, sir?
Give the order. You, over there. Do you have a clear view of this box?
Yes, sir.
Remember, when the time comes, shoot. Only if you have to, shoot to kill.
How will I know, sir?
You'll know. Monsieur le Vicomte,
are you confident that this will work?
Don't worry, Thelma.
Andre.
Very well. We are in your hands, monsieur.
My men are now in position, sir.
Go ahead, then.
Are the doors secured?
When the time comes.
Oh, Monsieur le Vicomte.
No buts. For once, Monsieur le Vicomte is right.
Seal my fate tonight. I hate to have to cut the fun short, but the joke's wearing thin. Let the audience in. Let my opera.
Thank you.
Catalino. Go away, for the trap is set, and waits for its
to that mud where words run dry.
My night. I will only free her. Have you no pity?
Your lover makes a passionate plea.
I love her. Does that mean nothing? I love her. Show some compassion.
The world show no compassion for me.
Christy, let me see her.
Be my guest.
never find.